Good morning all. Today we are going to see how the inductor will respond when it is connected to a sine wave under steady state conditions. So for that, let us assume there is an inductor having an inductance, self-inductance of L Henry, and it is connected to some supply, so some sinusoidal supply. Let us assume this supply is V is equal to V maximum sine omega t. Whenever the voltage is applied, it will produce some current. The phase will depend on the circuit parameters that we are going to derive. So whenever current passes through an inductor, it produces some flux. So that flux will link with its own inductance, that leads to the self-induced EMF. As per Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction, that self-induced EMF is given by minus L into di by dt. So EMF induced, E is induced in the coil, which is self-induced EMF. This self-induced EMF will always oppose the cause. Cause is my applied voltage. Or we can tell that if you apply the KVL in this loop, you will get this value of V plus E is equal to 0, or I can tell V is equal to minus E. That means it is minus of L into di by dt. Or I can write my value of the voltage is equal to L into di by dt. So this is the response of the inductor. So from this I can write my value of di is equal to V by L into dt. So I can substitute this di is equal to V maximum sin omega t dt divided by L. So if I want to calculate I have to do the integration. So you can do the integration, V maximum by L is constant. This becomes integration of sin omega t dt. So we know the integration of sin omega t will be equal to minus cos omega t divided by omega. Minus cos omega t divided by omega. So this I can write as V maximum by omega L into this minus cos omega t. I can write in the form sine of omega t minus 90 degrees. Sine of omega t minus 90 degrees. That will become equal to cos omega t. So this is my value of I. From this I can calculate that this value I can assume equal to the maximum value. So this I can write as I maximum sin omega t minus 90 degrees, where the value of I maximum is equal to V maximum by omega L. So this omega L is called as the inductive reactance of the coil, which is represented by X suffix L, or I am writing here XL is equal to omega L. What is omega? Omega is nothing but 2 pi F. This is 2 pi FL. This is inductive reactance of the coil. So I am just writing my value of I again. I can write as I maximum sin omega t minus 90 degrees. And we got the value of V as we have taken as a reference. This becomes V maximum sin omega t. So we can draw the phasors. If you draw the phasor form, so voltage phasor I am representing with V. It is a reference, so I am taking angle 0. But if you take the current vector, the current vector is lagging behind the voltage vector by an angle of 90 degrees. So we can tell that current is displaced from the voltage vector by an angle of 90 degrees, or it is lagging by 90 degrees. Whenever anything is lagging, we represent in the clockwise direction, and leading will be represented in counterclockwise direction. You remember here always these vectors are represented by RMS values. So let us try to calculate what is the instantaneous value of the power. So to calculate the instantaneous value, first I am drawing the waveform. This is my voltage waveform which I am taking as a reference. So here I am presenting voltage, current and instantaneous power. So current, just now we have derived, the current is lagging behind the voltage by 90 degrees. That means current waveform will start after 90 degrees. So current waveform is starting after 90 degrees. So this is the waveform, the current. This is my current. So if you want to calculate the instantaneous power, we know the instantaneous power V is equal to instantaneous voltage multiplied by instantaneous current. You can see the multiplication at any point. At this point, 0 multiplied by something will be 0. So as you are moving, the positive multiplied by negative. So automatically the power will be negative. It reaches maximum here. Again at this point, it reaches 0. Same way, it will come like this here. Same way, it will be negative here. And again it will be positive here. So this is plus minus, again this is minus and plus. So you can see here, for quarter cycle the power is in one direction, for another quarter cycle it is coming in another direction. again it is continuously changing. So we can tell that the inductor takes the power for one quarter cycle and returns the power for another quarter cycle. So this is my instantaneous value of V into I, or we can tell that the average value of the power will be equal to zero, because always your wattmeter will measure the average value. So let us try to derive it mathematically. So mathematically I can derive it as power P is equal to V into I. This is V maximum sin omega t, and the instantaneous value of the current is I maximum sin of omega t minus pi by 2. So this I can write as V maximum I maximum sin omega t. Sin omega t minus 90 degrees will be minus cos omega t. So I am writing minus sign. So this I can represent as minus V maximum I maximum by 2 into sin 2 omega t. This is the value I am getting. So if you want to calculate the average value, so average value, how to do the integration? Before that, you can observe here, it is also a sinusoidal wave, but having 2 times your supply frequency. That means it is the wave that is oscillating at 2 times your supply frequency. So if you take the average value or the average power, this average power will be equal to P is equal to 1 by 2 pi integration from 0 to 2 pi. We have to take for the full wave, multiplied by whatever we are getting. So this value we get is V maximum I maximum by 2 into minus sine 2 omega t into d omega t. So we have to do the full integration. If you do the integration of this term, double the frequency component for full cycle, it will become equal to 0, or we will get the average power is equal to 0. So we can tell that the average power consumed, or the power consumed by the inductor, is 0, and the property of the inductor is for one quarter cycle it takes the power and another quarter cycle it supplies the power back. So what is the maximum value of the instantaneous current? The maximum value of the instantaneous current will be equal to V maximum I maximum by 2, and the frequency will be equal to 2 times your supply frequency. That is a response of the power for through the inductor. So to further clarify this, let us take one example and try to solve it, so that all the basic concepts will be clear to you. So the example is a 0.014 Henry choke coil with negligible resistance is connected to a 220 volts 50 hertz supply. Determine, the first one asked is inductive reactance of the coil. So what is the inductive reactance of the coil? And the second one asked is what is the current flowing through the coil. And the third one they have asked, what is the power consumed by the coil. And the fourth one, what is the maximum energy stored in the coil, because always inductor stores the energy in the form of magnetic field. They are asking what is the maximum energy stored in the coil. So first thing, whenever any numerical is given, first you have to write what is the given data. The data is given that L is equal to 0.014 Henry and resistance is equal to 0, that means it is pure inductor, and the voltage is given as 220 volts and frequency is given as 50 hertz. So from this I can calculate my value of XL. XL is equal to 2 pi FL, 2 pi into 50 into 0.014. This will be my value of inductive reactance. If you substitute this, you will get this value as 4.4 ohms. So we can tell that the inductive reactance is equal to 4.4 ohms. Now the second part, it is asked what is the current flowing through this reactor. It will be equal to RMS value of voltage divided by inductive reactance. That gives your RMS value of the current. So this will be 220 multiplied by 4.4. So this will be equal to 50 amperes. And the third part, it is asked what is the power consumed. We know the average power consumed will be 0 in the inductor, so I am directly writing it. Or even if you derive with the instantaneous value, applying the derivation, you will get the same answer. Then it is asked what is the maximum energy that can be stored in the inductor. In an inductor, the energy stored in the case of DC is given by half L into I square. So here in the case of AC, the current is continuously varying. That means energy is not constant. It will take the energy and return back the energy. They are asking what is the maximum energy that can be stored. So maximum energy will be stored when current is equal to maximum. So I am writing half L into I maximum square. This becomes half into 0.014 into I maximum. I maximum is root 2 times of RMS value, root 2 times of 50 square. So if you calculate this, you will get it as 35 joules. I hope this concept of the inductor is completely clear to you. If you have any queries, you can leave your comments in the comment section below. I will answer from there. Thank you. Thank you very much.